This is an AMI This Week shortcut.
I'm Wade Brown for Accessible Media in Red Deer. I'm at the Red Deer Museum and Art Gallery, known as MAG, which also houses the Red Deer and District Archives. Every Monday and Wednesday afternoon, a group of local artists gather together here to spark their creativity.
Hi, I'm Lorna Johnson. I'm the Executive Director of the Red Deer Museum and Art Gallery. MAGSparks is an art program that we run twice a week, and it's designed for adults with developmental disabilities. This program started about 8 years ago, and we have some people that have been coming every day religiously for the whole 8 years, and then we have some new people. Every session, our two artists plan an art activity, so it might be a drawing activity or a painting activity, or sometimes they do ceramics or even some textile art. So they always are prepared to teach that activity and facilitate it. And we have some participants who like to come and they're doing their own thing, so they have their own art projects they're working on. They come and get their art supplies and sit down at a table and just sort of enjoy being in the community of artists who's here.
On the day we dropped by, the lesson was all about impressionist painting. Some followed the lesson plan, while others did their own thing.
And a lot of sort of short brush strokes.
CJ was working on a project, writing words using a pencil and white paper, but he doesn't like to limit himself.
What kinds of projects do you like to do?
All kinds.
To help CJ and others learn the different kinds of art, there are experts on hand.
Hi, I'm Janet Cole, and I'm one of the MAGSparks artists at the Red Deer Museum and Art Gallery. So we arrive and we get all set up, and we usually do a demonstration for everyone once they get settled in.
I might do something a little bit more like using the corner of my brush and having little teeny tiny brush strokes.
And then we just spend time helping them if they need help, or encouraging them, or giving them suggestions if they look like they need something. So a lot of folks, when they first come, they aren't sure what they're able to do, and they end up making really great pieces of art, and their confidence grows. It's a place to come and, one, they learn about art, but the other piece is it's kind of like a community. They become friends, they enjoy the social aspect of it, and they become more confident and feel more self-worth by coming here.
25-year-old Quincy tried his hand at painting using lots of blue. He enjoys coming to the program.
Why do you like MAGSparks?
I like doing different art.
Do you have a favorite project?
I like doing my own painting. I like doing watercolor, sometimes acrylic.
And tell me about the other people around you in MAGSparks. How do you feel when you're painting in a group like this?
I like the big group. They are nice.
Lorna believes programs like MAGSparks are very important.
I really believe in the transformative power of art. I think art making and creativity is important for everybody. Most days they have something to take home and put in their rooms, so sort of as a reminder of their creative activity and the experience they had. So I think that also has real value for them.
CJ summed up how many people feel about the program.
What have you learned about art?
It's perfect.
For more information about the program, visit reddeermuseum.com. For Accessible Media in Red Deer, I'm Wade Brown.